The network allows machines such as servers, workstations, or storage infrastructure to communicate with each other and to exchange data. It can be between them in a local network, but also with the outside world, particularly the internet. However, this openness makes the internal machines accessible to external individuals, and so potential threats. Indeed, the issue is that the internet is also a potential entry point for malicious actions, such as espionage or cyber attacks. Let's explain the components of network security, using the metaphor of defending a medieval castle. The goal of a network security architecture is to organize the information system in a manner that enables improved control, monitoring, threat detection, and, of course, responsive actions. The cornerstone of this perimeter defense is the firewall. A firewall secures a network by defining authorized or prohibited communications, both incoming and outgoing. Picture the firewall as the portcullis, separating the castle from the treacherous lands beyond. The firewall interconnects two or more networks of different security levels. Its goal is to filter communications between zones, analyze them, and then allow or reject them according to security rules. Common filtering criteria include the origin and/or destination of packets, using IP addresses and ports, options within the data, such as fragmentation or validity, the data itself, obviously, and even user authentication for modern firewalls. The second element of the network security architecture, linked to the firewall, is the DMZ. The DMZ is an isolated subnet separating the local network and a network considered less secure, like the internet. The DMZ hosts machines from the internal network that need to be accessible from the outside, especially when providing services to internet users, such as web server, proxy, reverse proxy, DNS server, etc. In this analogy, the second firewall is another portcullis that will protect the royal court. It serves as a buffer zone between the hostile unknown lands and the royal court. LAN servers are never directly exposed to the internet. Everything must first pass through the DMZ. This also means that in case of compromise of a service in the DMZ, the hacker will only have access to DMZ machines and not the local network. Now let's move on to the proxy. A proxy server is an intermediary server that allows a machine to access the internet. A proxy, our vigilant gatekeeper, acts as an intermediary, much like a knight standing guard at the castle gate. All internal requests must seek approval from this noble gatekeeper before venturing beyond the castle walls. In this case, the user first connects to the proxy server and sends the request. The proxy server then transmits the message to the remote server. Thus, each internal request must pass through the proxy to exit. What's the difference between a proxy and a firewall? Firewalls can block all or part of communications in both directions between connected networks, while a proxy essentially masks your internal network on the internet. In essence, the firewall allows only communications between proxy and the internet, and the proxy controls exchanges between the LAN and the internet. Now that we've seen the role of the proxy, let's explore what the reverse proxy is. The reverse proxy plays the opposite role of the proxy. For example, let's say the reverse proxy is guardian of the castle. Anyone wanting to enter the castle must pass through him. The reverse proxy allows an internet user to access internal servers. It centralizes and optimizes incoming flows from the internet to internal machines. IDS stands for Intrusion Detection System, aiming to identify any potentially malicious traffic, such as intrusion attempts, viral attacks, excessive flows, and unusual outbound traffic. The IDS plays the role of the watchtower sentinel. It's akin to a watchman atop the castle tower who, though vigilant, does not directly intervene. An IDS detects suspicious activity based on a standard, and if activities deviate from the norm, the IDS raises an alert. Let's move on to the IPS, for Intrusion Prevention System. The IPS reacts in real time by stopping recognized suspicious traffic, including blocking ports. Essentially, the IPS is like an IDS, but with blocking capabilities. In contrast, the Intrusion Prevention System acts as the vigilant castle guard. When it identifies suspicious activity, It reacts in real time, securing the castle gates and blocking the invaders. It intervenes by blocking the gates in case of suspicious activities. Now, one last thing, because there's a lot of confusion about it, is the difference between a firewall and an IPS. The role of an IPS is to detect attacks on a network from an attack signature database, like an antivirus, and block them if necessary. The role of a firewall is different because its purpose is to filter access by defining allowed or prohibited communications. Finally, there's a lot of confusion about the roles of different network security devices. This confusion is particularly linked to the fact that the next generation firewalls combine functionalities from different components. Modern firewalls can encompass all the security components we've discussed. Note that each component has already been covered in dedicated videos available in this playlist. So, if you want more information on a specific element, check out the dedicated video. Oh, and obviously don't forget to subscribe to support me to do more videos. See you soon!